since then, I never forget to say thanks. Give God thanks. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. When you forget to say thanks, you become ungrateful. And you know what I say about ungratefulness? Ungratefulness is worse than witchcraft. Amen? So give God thanks. Wow. Thanksgiving skit. Sister Yvonne Hall and Company. Sounds like a corporation. Come on down. Amen, somebody. Give them a hand as they come.
God, tell my enemies I am under the rock. Jehovah hides me. I am under the rock. I am under the rock, and the rock is higher than I. Jehovah hides me. I am under the rock. God, tell my enemies I am under the rock. Jehovah hides me. I am under the rock. Under the rock, and the rock is higher than I. Jehovah, hide me. I am under the rock. God, tell my enemies I am under the rock. Jehovah, hide me. I am under the rock. I am under the rock, and the rock is higher than I. Jehovah, hide me. I am under the rock. God, tell my enemies I am under the rock. Under the rock. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Send down the gospel rain. Send down the rain, send down the rain, send down the gospel rain. I want a revival in my soul. I want a revival in my soul. I must apply to the blood of Jesus to get a revival in my soul.
his wife could eat no lean. And so between the two of them, they licked the platter clean. Please porridge hot, peas porridge cold. Peas porridge in the pot, 9 days old. Some like it hot, some like it cold. Some like it in the pot, 9 days old.
Thanksgiving?
I don't want no stupid turkey.
The lovely food. You know, come on, baby. Look, guess what?
I don't want it.
All right.
What is this? What is this?
Are you feeling sick, hon? Guess what? I have a pre-Christmas gift for you and a Thanksgiving gift. Please calm down. Please.
I don't want no stupid present.
You know something? I've had enough of your antics, young lady. You ungrateful. You know what I'm gonna do? Do you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna take this lovely food, this wonderful present, and I'm gonna take it over to old Miss Mabel and her granddaughter. And you're gonna help me carry it. You understand me? So let's go right now. Right now.
And darling, look, darling, I got a fresh bread this morning and real butter, nice and sweet. Dip your finger in there and taste it.
Mmm, good.
That's good.
So we have just a little water and we have our bread and we're going to give God thanks, my child. Our Father, we thank you. My child, you hear somebody calling?
Yes, Grandma.
Miss Mabel, it's me.
We have company.
Miss Mabel.
Oh.
Hi, Camilla. How are you doing? I just thought, you know what? Let me bring my Thanksgiving gifts over and share you a Thanksgiving dinner.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Come, Rosie, come and sit beside Anne. Come. Over there, right beside Anne. Saying.
Come, Miss Roy, let me try and set.
Oh, Lord.
Because I just grab it up.
I haven't seen all this for a very long time.
Oh, wow.
And there, look what the Lord has done. Yeah. Put over water. I'm ready to start.
Whoops.
Oh, careful. We have
turkey, stuffings with trimmings, sweet potato pie, candied yams, and a beautiful tablecloth.
And look here, my child.
So let's sit to eat.
Okay. We were just about to say a prayer.
Oh, yes, that's right.
So let's say the prayer.
This is for you, sweetheart.
And sit over. Oh.
This is for you, darling.
And you get pressed.
Oh, you can imagine.
We look at it later.
Let's pray.
Oh, our Father, we thank you this day.
Yes.
We thank you for life.
Yes.
My God, I've never seen all these beautiful things for a very long time. Mm. So we give you honor and praise. We bless this meal, oh God, as we eat it. We give you praise. Glory, hallelujah. Amen.
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 You know something, Miss Mabel? I was there over there and I said to myself, you know what? I should share this meal with you. I learned so much, Miss Mabel, I learned today. Rosie, what did you learn today? That's all you learned, Rosie. What else you learned, Rosie?
To not be ungrateful.
Yes, don't be ungrateful.
Thankful
for everything that God gives to us. Right, Miss Mabel?
Yes, child.
We are
us all be grateful and give thanks.
My little company here.
Amen.
Look at these things.
Let's eat.
Yes, sir.
Right. Yum. Oh, may I have a piece of the bread here, please?
Yes, dear.
Are you serious or not?
Butter. Real sweet butter.
Thank you,
Rosie,
very much.
You want some of my bread?
Mmm. Miss Mabel, this bread is good, man.
Fresh bread from the bakery. Rosie, you want bread?
So, Rosie, you're not eating?
And you always love the egg.
Yeah. Oh, so you like bread? Turkey, right? Thanks be to God.
Yes, sir. And can you finish?
I know this one.
What's in this? Look here.
We thank thee each morning for a newborn day, where we may work the fields of new mown hay. We thank thee for the sunshine and the air that we breathe, O Lord. We thank thee. Thank thee for the rivers that run all day. Thank thee for the little birds that sing along the way. Thank thee for the trees and the deep blue sea, O Lord. We thank thee. Oh yes, we thank thee, Lord, for every flower that blooms, birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank thee every day as we kneel and pray, that we were born with eyes to see these things. Thank thee for the fields where the clover is grown. Thank thee for the pastures where cattle may roam. Thank thee for thy love so pure and free, O Lord. We thank thee. Birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank thee every day as we kneel and pray, that we were born with eyes to see.
Praise the Lord, church. What a professional skit. Let's give God another hand. He's worthy. And we learned from that skit that as diligent believers, we have to think on our feet. When the crisis came domestically with the daughter, the mother made a wise decision. She said, let's take this thing over to the neighbor. And it all got together over there. Amen? We have to know to double team sometimes. Give God the glory, He's worthy. Yeah. Hallelujah! Yeah. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let us get ready to give our Thanksgiving offering after such a relevant skit. I think it's fitting that we can give us unto the Lord. So let's get ready. The musician is going to play something very nice, and the singer is going to come, light this up, and we're going to give. Thank you.
Father, we thank you for the offering that was given today, O Lord. We pray that, God, it be used, they God, according to your will and according to your way. We bless you, we magnify and glorify your name. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Sure that he has done great things for us. I'm sure he has done great things for you. Amen. So don't be afraid to give God praise. Amen. Let's not wait until Thanksgiving to give God praise. Amen. So come on, let's put your hands together and give God some praise tonight. Hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. He is a mighty and an awesome God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Tonight we're going to be singing thanks. I give you thanks for all that he has done for us. Amen. So as we minister the song, you can give God thanks with us.
Oh,
Come on, church, say with me, delicious. Delicious. What a special rendition. Amen, somebody. You know, when I'm praising God like this, I get on a high. And I get what is called open eye visions. Would you like to know
come
what I just saw?
Everybody open your mouth and worship the Lord.
I'm going to share with you because
your
family.
Of the glory.
I just saw $20,000. Come give God a hand.
Come everybody all over the
world.
Open your mouth and worship. Lift your hands and bless them.
Hallelujah! Listen. You can't receive it without believing. Believe and receive if you not receive. And you will receive because God is not a liar. Amen, somebody? What he promises, he does. Amen, somebody? Dance Selection, SGCN, dance group. Come and represent in Jesus' name. Give them a hand as they come. Glory! Praise the Lord.
And some more stamina. Y'all parents need to pay me. But nonetheless, we want to thank God for what he has done for us, what he has given us, the most important, the gift of life. And when we have life, we can do a lot of things with that. Amen?
Wow.
Come on, everybody, open your mouth and worship the Lord. He's worthy of the glory. He deserves the praise today. Come on, everybody, all over the room, open your mouth and worship. Lift your hands and bless him in this place.
Your simple song. Belongs to you, oh Lord, yes.
y'all got it. Come on, say, my hallelujah. From the bottom of your heart, lift your voice. My hallelujah. Lord, my hallelujah. Yeah. Then we simply say, you deserve it. Real simple, say it, church. From the bottom of your heart, tell the Lord. Everything I give you, Lord. Everything I owe you, Lord, it belongs to you.
All of the glory belongs to you.
Y'all got it now. Come on, say it. All of the glory, Lord, belongs to you.
All of the glory belongs to you.
All of the glory, Lord, yeah.
All of the glory belongs.
Everybody, lift your hands right here and say, together one time. My hallelujah belongs to you. Everybody come on in concert and say it.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Navy SEALs for Christ. Amen, somebody? I don't know what you got from that. I got two revelations from that. They're not only good in the academy, where the teacher trained them, but it was also good in the foxhole, because they came out here and went to did business. Amen, somebody? Give them another half of doing business. Hallelujah! When you see me skipping and jumping like that, you know something got to be driving him. A man can't pretend for so long. He's going to faint. Amen, somebody? Amen. When my father was dying, he told me, he says, there's one thing you never let go, boy. You have unashamed, aggressive praise. I saw you all over the world. I would not, because it's covenant with me. I let you in the secret, it's covenant. Not just doing it because you're nice to do. I got a revelation. The second thing I want to tell you, God, just now. I said, God, when I see what those young people doing, I'm glad you know you found a creative way to keep me young. Age is just a number. And everywhere I go, I prove it. It's not me, it's him. Divine, give God a half of divine energy. Give God a half of divine energy. Glory, glory. Musical selection by our very own Sister Pat Tyndale. Give her a hand, she comes. Wow!
Good evening, church.
Good evening.
First Chronicles 16, verse 34 says, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever." We thank him in all things.
Thank you.
to God. Glory to God. I just got another revelation. You can't be a place like this and don't get any revelation. Amen, somebody? Sister Pat uses our songs as weapons of righteousness. Give her a hand for that weapon of righteousness. Glory to God. There are certain things just make the anointing come on you. You just feel God's help. Amen. There's not no devil in hell can do about it. Who God bless? Who God bless? Who God bless? Break and reverse the curse. Who God bless? You to put God first. Who God bless? You'll find your purse. Give God a hand for your purse. Amen, somebody. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Now we have this distinguished moment in time. About the 6:30 hour, making good time too. We have our possible first female district superintendent of New York City. You see, she's teaching me to think big and talk right. Amen, somebody? The distinguished honorable Teresa, I don't know what the L is, but I'll just stick love in there. Teresa Love Brown. Amen. We love you, Sister Brown. So come on with the love of God and pour living water in our souls. I'll be having a ringside seat and I'll be shocked in the glory. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Thank you very much. Good evening again, everyone.
Good evening.
Good to see you, and we're so thankful. We are very, very, very thankful. That's why we're here. And I just want to praise God. We have a lot to praise Him for. And we just want to exalt His name and adore Him because He's Lord of Lords and King of Kings. And we just want to give Him thanks. Praise God, praise God, praise God. You have heard the scripture read already, so I won't read it again, but I'll just go ahead and pray and then I'll begin. Heavenly Father, again, we thank you. We come with grateful hearts because we thank you for redemption. We thank you for salvation. And you have given us hope. And because of that hope, we are here rejoicing and praising you and giving you thanks. I pray that you will use me in a mighty way. Speak through feeble lips of clay in the name of Jesus. Unctionize me, Lord, and help me to speak, thus said the Lord, as you want me to speak. And I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Now, you heard the scripture read about the 10 lepers. We are talking about one thankful man. You heard the story, right? They were all 10 of them, they were unclean. And you know, in Bible days, leprosy is a serious disease, right? And in the Old Testament, when they were unclean as long as they had the disease. And they weren't allowed to mix with clean people, who did not have that disease. The ones with the leprosy had to be quarantined all by themselves. They live outside the camp and nobody mixed with them, just themselves. And if somebody who doesn't know is among them, walking near them, they have to cry out, unclean, unclean, unclean. And right there, whoever doesn't know, will have to pull away real fast. Because that person is unclean. So they had no human contact. So you know we are social people. God made us as social beings. We need that love and that human contact with each other. They didn't have that because of the leprosy. But thank God, thank God. And you know, leprosy, it's like sin, the disease of sin. The sin disease right now is even worse than leprosy, I can tell you that. Without salvation. But thank God for salvation. Because some people are not even aware that they have that disease of sin. It is a disease. And it's only the blood of Jesus Christ. Only the blood of Jesus Christ. So that's why we rejoice. That is why we rejoice, because of the blood of Jesus Christ. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. The lepers called to Jesus. When Jesus saw the lepers, he entered the village, of course. When the lepers, they realized, because, you know, they're always trying to get healed. They didn't give up. So anywhere Jesus was, if they heard that he was coming someplace, they would get some help or you know, whatever way they could get there. They would find that place and they would hope and pray that they would get healed. But thank God. How many of them were healed? Anybody remembers? 10 of them. But how many of them returned to give thanks? One. Okay. We have that Samaritan one. That's right.
We have to be thankful. We have to have thankful hearts. And you know what that reminds me of? We should not take anything for granted. You know, we wake up this morning, we wake up in our right minds. We can see and we can talk and we can eat. And we should not take that for granted. That's a miracle because many people died last night. We didn't hear of that. We don't know of it. Many people did not make it through the night. Just walking on two legs, that's a miracle too. We don't have four legs like the other animals. You know, like, of course, we walk on two. And that is why when a baby is born, the baby cannot walk yet because the legs are not strong enough. But just walking on 2 feet, think of it. You're here, you're balancing on 2 feet. That's a miracle. You know we are supposed to give thanks for that. That's right. So let us not forget that we ought to give thanks. And let us always, always be thankful and be grateful. And not just the spoken words, but in our hearts and our attitude and our actions. Everything should give praise and worship to God. Because, you know, brothers and sisters, we are not just saved to escape hell or to just go to heaven. We are saved to praise God and to worship Him. Right? We have to worship from the very, very depths of our heart, the very depths of our soul, our entire being. Okay? And that is why the person who is unsaved can't even worship God because they don't know, they don't understand. They're blind, spiritually blind. So they don't even know that they should give thanks. And that is why when someone comes to the Lord, it's such a great light, you know. It's like night and day. So let us continue to praise the Lord. Let's continue to praise God. And let us not fail to spread the news of salvation. Let us not fail to spread the good news of salvation. The unsaved needs to hear it. We must carry out that great commission. We must carry out that great commission because there are people out there in leprosy. I compare it as that, you know, or it's even worse than that, in sin. Okay? And they need to hear the gospel of salvation. And that is why we should not fail to pray for missionaries and to talk to our neighbors, with anyone with whom we come into contact. Let us not, if they're not saved, let us find a moment, some opportunity. Let us not miss those opportunities. Let us not miss opportunities to present the gospel. Sometimes you will never get that opportunity again. How many times have you seen someone, the Holy Spirit said, you could talk to someone, tell that person about Jesus Christ. And you said, well, I'm so shy, or the person might not receive me very well, and all of that. Then we miss that opportunity. We miss that chance. And then sometimes the Holy Spirit will remind us. But we don't know what God is doing, and if God is using us to tell someone about the gospel of Jesus Christ, let us always be obedient. Because sometimes it is that person's last chance. How would you feel to know that, okay, you could have said something, and that person could have responded? The person has a choice of rejecting Christ or accepting salvation. But of course, if they didn't get the chance, you know, that's why in Romans it says, how will they hear if someone doesn't tell them? So we need pastors and missionaries and evangelists and all the leaders and everyone, all of us Christians, to tell them and to make it known to them. Okay, so we say here, leprosy pictures the sinful state of us all. And that's what it is. Jesus Christ, have mercy upon us. So when we accept salvation, when we hear that gospel and we accept salvation, Jesus Christ has mercy upon us, right? He has mercy on us. It's like the leper, the person with the leper, right? Leprosy, right? The person with the leprosy is saying, Lord, have mercy. Jesus Christ, have mercy. And that leper or that person with the leprosy is hoping to get physical healing. But we know that when we accept Jesus Christ as personal Lord and Savior, we are healed. We have been born again. And we have started on a journey of spiritual growth. And that is why we grow spiritually, because we have been born again. And we have taken a different direction. First, we are over here going that way. Now we are on a new road. And we are walking and living for Jesus Christ. So let's be thankful. Let us be thankful. And to know that we have salvation, we have to continue on that road. Okay? We cannot give up. We have to continue. Regardless of what is happening around us. Regardless of what the challenges may bring. We cannot give up, right? The Holy Spirit is there as our helper. Before Jesus left, he said he would send the helper, and he's faithful. He has kept his promise. So if we really want to continue to grow and to do what God has asked us to do, we just have to ask. We just have to pray, all right? In our weakness, in our weak moments, when someone is difficult to love, We should ask for grace. Lord, please help me to love this person. We are supposed to love them because the Bible says we should love God with all our heart and mind and soul and strength and our neighbor as ourselves, not just our physical neighbor who lives beside us to the right or the left or in front of us, but anyone, anybody, okay? And another thing, too, when we love them, we'll want to tell them about the good news of salvation. We want them to escape, too, right? Evangelism is like one person telling another person where to find bread, right? Where to find food. Okay, that's our spiritual food. When we start growing and we read the Bible and we pray and all of that, the scriptures, that's our spiritual food. Okay? So let us remember what we are called to do and that we should be thankful. And out of a heart of thankfulness, we want to share the love of God. I mean, if someone is a Christian and has that love of God in them and that thankfulness and being grateful, you want to share. You don't want to keep all of that to yourself. You can't. You have to share it. So let us remember now that we have things in common with the lepers. Those 10 lepers, we had it before we were saved. But now we're healed. We're cured. We're cured right now, okay? But we have not arrived yet, okay? So we are not boasting. We are just trying to tell others. And we are just praising God and exalting God and lifting up his name. That's what we are doing. Praise the Lord. Let's praise him. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, that one was thankful. We don't want to be like that one. We want to be like that one, but not like the nine. Not like the nine who didn't return to give thanks, right? We want to be like that one, but we don't want to be the only one. All of us, we want to give thanks, right? Right? We want to give thanks. Because if all of us are saved and only one out of all of us is giving thanks, then something is wrong with that. All right? So we are all pray, and we all praise God differently. We have different personalities. All right? Some of us jump and run like Reverend Mitchell and all of that. We praise him differently. But we have that grateful heart, in us, right? We are still thankful. All right? And there are some great testimonies. You have heard great testimonies. And there are some private ones that people don't want. Would not want everyone to know, but they are still grateful. So when you see someone running around or skipping around, leave them alone. Don't look at them funny because they know what God has saved them from. Right? People have received healing, physical healing, cancer, diabetes, whatever you name it. People have received healing in the name of Jesus because God is a miracle working God. Still doing miracles. Still in the miracle business. Still in the miracle business. And we are so grateful. We should be so grateful. Oh my God. And when those little minor problems come, because Satan, he never gives up. He's going to continue whatever he started in the Garden of Eden with Adam and Eve, that deceiver. He's still trying. But when he tries, we know he's already defeated. So we just praise the Lord and we move on. Do not let him get you down. Do not let him get you down. Rebuke him in the name of Jesus. We are human beings and we might feel, but we know whom we have believed and we are more than conquerors. We are more than conquerors. And let us thank God for what we have because we are not in heaven yet. We're still down here on earth. So little things will happen, of course, but we know that we have been redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ. We have been redeemed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let us keep pressing on that upward way. Let us keep pressing on that upward way. On Thursday when we had that snow, I was just thinking of it. The following day, the mayor had a press conference and they were, asking him questions. How could they miss that opportunity? They were not prepared and all of that. But I said to myself, I was talking to my husband, and I said, you know what? People need to know who God is. They need to know that we don't have the call and that God is in control. And things can happen. The pattern can change swiftly. And I know that the weather people, they are doing an excellent job. But at the same time, God is in control. And humanity needs to remember that they don't have it all. There's a God in heaven. And you know what I was saying too? I said, when that rapture comes, the headlines will say, thousands of Christians disappeared. Thousands of Christians have disappeared. And you know what? Those who didn't make it, those ones who thought they would have made it, they're going to say, what happened? Some of them might even go to the church, to the pastor, and say, how come you let me miss the rapture? What happened? You know, you never know. People will always have excuses, and they will always say, what happened? You caused it. And they might even blame the pastor. You never know who they might blame. But it's on us. We are accountable. We're all of the age of accountability. So let us not fool ourselves. Let us know that God is in control. And things are going to happen that is out of the hands of mankind. And they need to be reminded of that. And take it for granted. When that rapture comes, it's going to be on a regular day or not. We don't know when. So if somebody's going to give you a date, you know that's wrong. Because we know not the day nor the hour. But we just have to be ready. We have to be prepared. And the next day, life is going to go on just the same. There'll be people going about their business and going to work just the same. And the gospel will be preached, but it's going to be harder for anyone to get saved. The church is already raptured, and I'm sure those who have been left behind will want to listen to the gospel. Yes, and the mark of the beast and all of that. People will be running to the churches. People will be getting saved, yes, but it's harder because the everlasting gospel will be preached. And all of that. We don't know the details, and we don't want to start going into the details to say A, B, C, 1, 2, 3, but people need to be aware of this. So we have to be ready. Don't wait to be left behind then to try to get saved when you have to take the mark of the beast. Try to go in the rapture. God has cleansed us. Jesus Christ died for us. We have salvation, regeneration, redemption, adoption, justification, all of that. And we are so very, 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 very grateful. And guess what happened? Money cannot buy any of that. A title cannot buy any of that. Okay? And money is just a temporary thing that we use down here. If we love it too much, we're in trouble too, because the love of money is the root of all evil. All right? So let us know that whatever we have, we can't worship it. Godliness with contentment is great gain. I'm not saying that money is not useful. It is useful because we need to pay our bills and all of that. But let us not overdo it now. Let us know that we are heading for heaven. Let us know where our treasure is. And let us be thankful. Oh, I'm sorry. Now, God is so good to us. He saves us. And just like he cleansed those lepers. And guess what? We have the fruit of the Spirit. You all know about the fruit of the Spirit in Galatians 5:22. And we're going to praise God for that because we need the fruit of the Spirit to live down here. Don't you think so? Every day we are confronted with something. We need all nine of them. We don't need, it's not like nine separate fruits where you say, I like this one or I have this one or I don't have that one. As Christians, we must have all parts, all nine parts, because they will help us to live here until the rapture comes or if God chooses to take us physically. But we have to be so grateful and so thankful of the peace. We all need peace. We all need peace, don't we? What did the angel said? Peace on earth and goodwill toward man. Now, what is peace? Peace is contentment, unity between people. Now, you know, in this, we live in a very diversified world. Different cultures, different races, different people. And there are some people who feel that, okay, because I'm white or because I'm Caucasian, they feel that they're better than another race. That should not happen. All right? And that should not prevent us from having peace. But there are some people, they spend their time trying to get rid of someone else who has a different color. Where's the peace? Where's the peace? But we need that peace of God. It's a state of assurance, lack of fear, a sense of contentment. It is fellowship, harmony, and unity between individuals. Peace is freedom from worry, disturbance, and oppressive thoughts. We are concerned sometimes, but we shouldn't just go around just worrying and crying and giving up. Because we know whom we have believed. We believe, we trust in the true and living God. So we should not go around with a long face feeling sorry for ourselves. Because we walk by faith and not by sight. So even when we don't see the help coming, we know that we serve a God. It's coming. It's coming. We serve a God who is mighty and awesome and faithful. What about joy? You know, does it depend on circumstances? Am I going to be happy this moment? Oh, things are going well. Oh, and then the next moment we're so sad. No, because guess what happened? It does not depend on the circumstances around us. It depends on that joy within our soul. Because once we are saved, we have that everlasting joy bubbling up within our hearts. and the devil cannot take it away. The devil did not give it to us, and he cannot take it away. He cannot take it away. We have that joy and the peace that passes all understanding. So let us hold on to what we have. Let us know what we have and who we are. Because if we don't know what we have or who we are, we just go around like ordinary people. But we know that we are saved through the miracle of God and the miracle of Jesus Christ. And we have that blood that washes us clean. And just to mention patience. Sister Joseph mentioned patience when she brought in those kids. Give them a hand again. Did they do a great job? Great job. She mentions, thank you. Yes, thank you. She mentions patience. We do need patience. Every step of the way, everything we do. I'm sorry. We need that patience to keep us going. Because guess what happened? The devil is alive. And he's going to present a situation that will require our patience. And what happens if we don't have the patience? The fruit of the Spirit, we don't have that. We could get very irritable, very upset, and say and do the wrong things and sin in our hearts and get bitter. But we don't want to do that because we have patience. Patience. So let's remember what we have. And we're not faking it either. It should come naturally. If you have it, you have it. You either have it or you don't have it. If you have it, I'm sorry. It will be seen. It will be seen. So let us not pretend. We can't pretend. That one we can't pretend. No, kindness, all of that. And gentleness, faithfulness, goodness, all of that. We need all nine parts. We need them because we are going to have situations where that is required to get us through it. Because God is faithful. And you know what? He gives us what we need to get through down here. We have the Holy Spirit as our helper to help us. He gives us what we need. He doesn't just save us and leave us alone. He gives us what it takes. And we are so grateful to God because he's awesome. He's mighty. And let us not listen to the voice of Satan. Let us not, because Satan will plant doubt. He's the father of lies. But let us listen to God. Let us know whom we have believed. Let us know that we have been healed spiritually, right? And we are growing. We have been healed of leprosy. You know, we don't know. Some of us have never seen this. I've never seen it. We have read about it. We have heard about it. I don't know if it's still happening now. Maybe sometimes there might be a disease that is similar to that. We don't know. But there are many other physical diseases. But guess what happened? We have been healed. We have been blessed. And we want to thank God for taking good care of us. And let us remember that we should not keep all of this to ourselves. People should know. They should see us and know that's a Christian right there. Because you know what? Some people might not take up the Bible. They don't might not own the Bible. They might not take up their Bible and read it every day. But if they work with you, or they live on your block and they see you very often, they are noticing you, they're seeing the love of God. They're reading you right there. And they could see the love of Jesus Christ in you. They could see the fruit of the nine parts of the fruit of the Spirit. They could say, there goes a Christian. And that alone could motivate them to want to become a Christian. I want to be like that person. I want what you have. Tell me what you have. How are you like this? You know, so we have to be careful too, because that's a testimony too, and that's evangelism too. That's carrying out the Great Commission. Another thing we have to be careful of is ethnocentrism. To be ethnocentric, I'll break it down for you. There, you know, when missionaries go overseas to evangelize, if they think that their culture is so much better than the others, than the culture in which they are working, some of them might not want to do what they should do, right? Even the buildings, they might want to make all the churches look like American churches, you know. But we have to evangelize in their culture. They have to live in their culture, and they have to see the love of God through their culture and experience it through their language and through their culture. So we have to be careful of ethnocentrism. And it, all it means is that one person or one culture might feel that my culture is superior to the others and we are the best and there's none like us. So when we are evangelizing, we have to be careful of that too. Because if we think that way, we might not want to tell people or to evangelize the way we should. Remember Jonah in the Bible? Exactly, with the Ninevites. He didn't want, it's a different culture, different people. He had something against them. He was supposed to go there, God sent him to evangelize and to preach so they could be saved. He didn't want that. But God, he couldn't run away from God because God said you have to go. And that was it. So we have to be careful of that too. Or we talk to other people from other cultures and all of that, because the love of God should help us to minister to them just like we would in our own culture here. So we don't look at them as inferior, because if we look at them as inferior, it might affect the way we present the gospel to them. Or we might feel this is not good enough for them. Or we give them partially, just a part of it. But let's give them the whole deal, the whole thing, just as if it's your brother or your sister or your parents. Love them, regardless. So we're here, we have hope because of Jesus Christ. And that is why we are here worshiping and praising and giving thanks. There are many people in many parts of the world who cannot do this. It's illegal. They cannot own a Bible. They cannot pray. They cannot worship. They couldn't have a Thanksgiving service. Even some missionaries who are in some areas right now evangelizing, they would probably like to have a nice Thanksgiving service and invite everyone and tell them about the American culture with our Thanksgiving service and all of that. But they can't do that because it's illegal and they would get in trouble. We have the 1040 window. We're in that area where we have the most deprived people. They're uneducated, they have not heard the gospel yet, and they are the most abused people. They have not heard the gospel yet. So we have to pray that long-term missionaries will go there, because missionary trips are getting very fashionable now. You know that, I'm not saying anything is wrong, but that's great. The short-term mission trips, and they go and they do great, like we went to Jamaica and did, our church went. But we need some long-term missionaries to live with the people and to show them the love of God, to live among them, right? So, and sometimes mission boards can't find those people. They'll go for a year or go for, you know, a year or two. But we need them to know the love of God. Just like we are rejoicing and dancing and praising God, they need that too, because Jesus Christ died for them, all right? They need to be cured too, just like we have been cured. So let us continue to be grateful. And our gratefulness should help us to spread the gospel. And you might say, well, I'm not a missionary. But guess what happened? You're a Christian. We're all Christians. And we are asked to spread the gospel to anyone, a child, a young person, an adult, wherever we go. And I know in this culture, people are, you know, told not to talk to strangers, of course, because that's for safety. But at the same time, a stranger might need your help. You will have to use your discretion, all right? A stranger might need your help. A stranger might need a smile. A stranger will need to be encouraged by you. You have to give encouragement, and most of all, if the person is not saved, and you know that, you have to provide the gospel, to spread the good news of salvation. Sometimes people accept salvation on their deathbed. It's the last moment, and they said, okay, and it's good that they have that last moment. Sometimes people don't have that last moment. Things happen and they don't have that last moment, like the thief on the cross. So let us remember them. Let us love them. Let us love people. If we love them as we should love them, we want to use up all the opportunities. Ask God for boldness. That's where I got it from. I was the shyest little girl ever. Shy, shy, shy. Even my mother was telling me that when I was growing up, I would not say, you know, in a day I would just say a few words. She knew that I could speak. I didn't have like a problem that I couldn't speak. But she was always concerned, why am I so quiet? When I was growing up, they would tease me and say, do you have egg in your mouth? You're not talking, you're so quiet. I don't understand. I was just, you know, and then, but God called me in the ministry and gave me that boldness. And, you know, it's God, because it's not me. Because I still feel that I have a little shyness. I am not the first one to be out there to say, okay, I will do this, I will do that. You know, in public, to speak publicly. But the love of God compels me. And God has called me. And I look back and said, oh my God, look at how God has called me. I mean, I didn't think, but God knows what he's doing. I can't question God for calling me. I just have to praise him and make sure that I'm obedient. And I just want to praise God and thank him. God has been grateful to me. All right? God, I'm very grateful to God. And God has blessed me in many, many ways. And I just want to show thanks to him. I just want to show gratitude. I just want to praise God. He has been very, very helpful to me. And salvation. Even coming here, I didn't plan to. It was not in my plans. But God brought me here. It was never in my plans. And I said, God. And God is very creative too. He's very, very creative. Very creative. very, very creative. I just wanted to stay home, take care of my mother. My mother was back home at the time, and I said, well, that's what I'm going to do. I had it planned out my way. But God had different plans, and then I have to be obedient. So let us be obedient. And sometimes you don't get to minister in your comfort zone, but because of what God has done for us, because of our gratitude to God, we find out we have to minister out of our comfort zone. But we can't say, well, I'm just going to minister where I'm very, very, very 100% comfortable. Suppose you're 50% comfortable. Are you going to say, no, God, I can't evangelize? No, God, I can't do this? We still have to do that because we are grateful. So out of a grateful heart, we sang, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. New mercies I see. So all of that should remind us. Every day we are reminded of God's goodness to us, and we are indeed grateful. At this moment, we are going to, I don't see Reverend Pascal, he's supposed to give the closing remark, where I give the vote of thanks. But we also have a song. So I'll just hand that over to Reverend Mitchell. We have a song. Jesus saves. Jesus saves. Thank you.
Let's give Lady Brung a hand for that. Reverend Brung, praise the Lord. And we're going to sing Jesus Saves by the praise team. They're going to help us.
Praise the Lord. We have heard the joyful sound. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Spread the tidings all around. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Yeah, the news to every land. Climb the sea and cross the waves. Onward, peace, the Lord's command.
Say amen. If you're saved, then you know it. Say amen. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. What a service. A word comes to me right now as we wrapping up. Say with me, overflow. God, give us the overflow tonight. Praise the Lord. I would like to invite First Lady to do the honors in the absence of illustrious pastor. Yeah. To just give us an altar call, closing prayer. You know, anybody can stand and just pray and
praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God is good, amen. There's nothing that we experience in this life, once we've said, God, have your way, that we, you know, we can have that assurance, yes. And we can say thank you. And not only thank you just by words, but in our response to him, our response to his call, to live a life that he has created us to live. Yes? So the call goes out. Jesus saves. Jesus saves. So if there's anyone tonight you not sure of your salvation, you're not sure, maybe you started the walk how many years ago, and you know how we have that saying, life happens and stuff and stuff and stuff and stuff. And somehow we get distracted. Somehow we, you know, come off the tracks a little. But God is saying the opportunity is here. The opportunity is here to get back on track. Because he is there and he's able to keep us. He's able to keep that which we've committed unto him against that day. So now is a good time to say, Lord, have your way. Now is a good time to say, Lord, I reaffirm, I recommit, I rededicate myself. Because when I look back, what's that song that says, when I look back from something, I can't remember, the words are coming right now, but the person was singing the song, that when they look back over their lives and they see where Lord has brought them from, there's no way they could not say thank you, Lord. And one way of giving thanks to God tonight is saying, Lord, I give myself afresh to you. I recognize how much you love me, and I want to respond to that love by giving my life afresh to you. Amen. Anybody here tonight want to say, Lord, just wave your hands. Lord, I give myself away. I give myself afresh to you. No, nothing am I going to hold back, but I'm going to give myself afresh to him. Shall we stand? Let us pray. Father, we thank you so much for your love for us. We thank you for that gospel call that says Jesus saved. And that one time, God, that came to us and we recognized, God, that we needed your salvation. We needed, Lord, to have our sins forgiven. We needed, oh God, a new lease on life. We needed, oh God, a fresh start. And you have said that I could be a new creature in Christ. And we gave our lives to you. And you've been a good, good Father. You have protected us. You've provided for us. Oh God, you have brought us, the songwriter says, a mighty long way. I've come this far by faith. And this, our God, in this Thanksgiving time, we say thank you. We say thank you for all that you have done. We say thank you for all that you're doing. We say thank you for all that you will do, because we know, God, that you're not done with us yet. And we pray, oh God, that you would help us as we respond to your goodness, as we respond to your faithfulness, as we respond to your mercy, as we respond to your grace, that we would respond in obedience to you. And we say tonight that we love you. And we say, Lord, afresh in you, have your way. Have your way. Have your way. We bless you, we honor you, we give you thanks, and we give you praise once more in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated.
Thank you. All right, I just want to give a quick vote of thanks. Thank you for coming, first of all, because without you, it would be just the benches. We couldn't perform to the benches. We want to thank Reverend Pascal, who gave the opening prayer. Our worship team for coming back this
appreciate it. Then we have our sanctuary choir. Thank you, Reverend Dr. Lee. Thank you very much for getting the choir out. We appreciate it. And then we have our dance selection. Oh, Sister Joseph, those little angels. Oh, my God. Give them a hand. Oh, my Lord. Great, great job. It takes a lot of patience, a lot of diligence, a lot of work. But God will reward all of you. We can't pay you. There's nothing we can do to pay you, but God will give you your reward. Okay, then we have our musical selection, Sister Pattindale. Always a pleasure hearing you. Thank you. All right. And then we want to, before we do the benediction, and if I miss any name, forgive me, please. We want to thank those who decorated. We came Friday night and we decorated. Okay. Thank you. We had planned to do that on Saturday, but we had more helpers for Friday, so we decided to go ahead with Friday evening because there were more helpers. But Brother Hines, who bought the fruits for us, and Sister Dixon went with him. This is what he has been doing every year for a number of years. Now that he's going away, I don't know who's going to step up. We need a new person to. But God will provide. We want to thank you very much, Brother Peter Hines. Thank you for buying the fruits. Thank you very much. And if I miss anyone, please forgive me. But before we do the benediction, I just want to remind you, this year I want to do it a little differently. We're going to ask you to form a line, and the council members will give out the fruits. I have some bags over there. Sister Hallford and Sister Charmaine and Sister Devika and others will hand you whatever you need in a bag. You might have preferences. You might say, well, that whatever that you request, we'll try to grant you your request. But we're going to do it very orderly this year. And those who are upstairs, we won't leave you out. You can come down and join the line. And we want everyone to get something. And the children will get their baskets, whatever is in their baskets. And I want to mention Sister Jennifer Samson. She brought these three pumpkins from her garden at home. Very good. I want to give her a hand for that. Very good. And instead of having one person getting all of that, if we could get a knife, we could ask someone to cut them. We could slice that up so everybody gets a piece of it. That would be good. I don't know who wants to volunteer to do that. We could get a knife from the kitchen. So, yes, and we could slice that up. But we're going to do this in order. And again, I want to say thank you and God bless you. And we'll now have our benediction.
May we stretch our hands out for the benediction, please. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. And remember to give thanks every day. It's not only today. Every day is a day we give thanks.